Are you ready? It's time to go back to business. Now, COVID-19, as bad as it may be, has actually changed consumer behavior. That is how customers and how people interact and buy stuff. And it has also changed several business trends. Now, in order to restart your business, follow the right approach to actually growing your business in 2020 and in the future, you need to know about these trends, and you also need to know about how consumers are spending their time online, how they are shopping, how everything has changed ever since COVID-19 has hit us, and most importantly, how can you restart your e-commerce store, or if you have been waiting on the sidelines, how can you start your e-commerce store on the right foot? Now, because of COVID-19, a lot of businesses as well as people realize the online benefit. Now, what is the online benefit? Now, before COVID, there was a large chunk of population that still believed the traditional approach to business, that still believed, you know, the brick and mortar route. But more and more people are realizing that how a lot of stuff that you do in the physical world can actually be done online. Whether it comes to education, shopping, recreation, entertainment, a lot of different things. Now, this shift to online was already happening for several years, but what COVID has done is that it has accelerated that shift to online. But it's not just about consumers. Businesses have started realizing that their employees can actually work from home and generate a similar amount of productivity. And this benefit is obvious to a lot of employees as well, with good internet connections, of course. And what this means for e-commerce is that a lot more people will be spending time at home, a lot more people will be shopping online, and I'll come to all the trends and how it has evolved in the past few months in just a bit. Now, according to a report by Facebook and BCG, I'll link the report in the description below, there have been a lot of changes in like consumer behavior as well as changes of certain trends. Certain trends have been reversed, certain trends have accelerated that were already happening, and new habits have started to form in the mind of consumers. Now, of course, one of the trends is like personal hygiene, washing your hands, sanitizing and all of that. Now, I'm not going to talk about hand sanitizers and how profitable it has been for hand sanitizer manufacturing companies, no. This video is not about that. This is about more deeper trends and more prolonged trends that are going to last in the near future. People have started embracing digital products and services. There has been an accelerated adoption of e-commerce. They've started thinking more and more about health and wellness. And one of the biggest new habits that are forming is the do-it-yourself or DIY. Which is a big opportunity. Now, in the past few months, I have had some of my most profitable months on my own e-commerce stores. And the main reason why this happened is because I was prepared. Well, what does it mean? Well, because I've been importing products and I've been storing products in my 3PL warehouse. So I had inventory and I was able to advertise in all these months. Advertising costs had gone super low and I was able to take advantage of the lack of advertisers in the ecosystem, which resulted in super, super profitable days for me. That trend still continues because more and more people have started shopping online than ever before. You won't believe the insane return on ad spends I've seen in the past few months. It's been a crazy, crazy time. But hey, it wasn't without challenges. Even I faced certain like transportation issues, shipping costs had increased. But the only thing that saved me is that I always had backup inventory with me. So it was all about future inventory being more expensive, but still it wasn't like unmanageable. It was still manageable. There were a few frustrating days, you know, when shipping costs randomly increased or, you know, my suppliers say ran out of inventory or like material, raw material. So there were all these mix of mini challenges that happened in the past few months, but all of them were things that I could take care of. Some took a few days, some took a few weeks, but everything got sorted out in the end. Now, when it comes to sourcing, I want to open up your mind, open up your horizon, and I want you to think a little bit beyond dropshipping. So while dropshipping is good for like testing products and seeing what product is working for your store, it is not good in the long term because, see, if you want to take advantage of certain situations like the past few months, like I have, well, you need to have inventory stored with you. So I want to talk about two important ways in which you can source products. Well, one is, of course, buying in bulk from China and other places and then storing it in a 3PL warehouse, the third party logistics warehouse in the US, where you can ship out your products even if the supply chain gets broken, if you have excess inventory lying with you. Now, what this does is this keeps you in control because you're not dependent on other suppliers or you're not dependent on other people to source products or source orders as they come to you, which is basically the dropshipping model. Because AliExpress shipping times and all of these became super high during the COVID phase, pretty much everything came to a standstill. Well, for a lot of people, not for me. If you want to have a long-term sustainable business, like I keep talking about, you need to make sure that you are storing inventory of your best-selling products. The other emerging trend is to go with US suppliers, or basically go with suppliers that are based out of the US and as well as alternates to AliExpress. So there are a few marketplaces out there that you should be going to and checking out. So just have a look at all of these portals and talk to their team and see how they can help your business. There are portals like Zendrop and Spocket and CJ Dropshipping. They have also started in the US. And of course, there's eBay US for sourcing your products. So just go to ebay.com, filter using North American or US suppliers, and you're good to go. Just have a look at all of these places, look at all of these portals, and see whether they can actually help you in sourcing products at a much quicker pace, and they can help in fulfilling your orders at a much quicker pace than AliExpress. Now, when it comes to what people are actually buying, I want to talk about a few product categories that are not hand sanitizers and personal hygiene. But when you think about it, as more and more people are spending more time in their homes, as more and more people are becoming more DIY or do-it-yourselfers, so what this does is it opens up an opportunity for selling a lot of different type of products. Personally speaking, before the lockdown, I already had an idea because other countries had started going into lockdown. So I actually ordered a few things beforehand. Things like an automatic, like, you know, a vacuum cleaner, robot vacuum cleaner, which I'd never thought I would need in India because we have help here, but you can't get help during lockdown. And even now, we don't have help coming into our house on a regular basis. So the robot vacuum cleaner helps out quite a bit. We even ordered a dishwasher just after the lockdown. So we are actually moving towards like a more self-sustainable model where we can, you know, take care of the house and take care of household things on our own. So which brings me to the first category, of course, household items, household accessories, household supplies. So all of these are interesting product categories that are growing. In the same way, of course, personal care products, you know, just to give you an example, like not a lot of people will be going to salons, right? So you have waxing strips for ladies that can be a big seller, at-home spa kits, several makeup items that can do really well in this time. So personal care is also one big growing category. As people spend more time inside, they need to move around a little bit. So of course, another category to go for is exercise accessories. And don't forget vitamins and supplements. Now, as more and more people are spending money online, well, how can you collect those payments on your e-commerce store? Well, using platforms like PayPal. Now, what PayPal is doing is they are giving a fee rebate offer of up to $100 when you enable PayPal on your Shopify store for the first time. I'll give a link where you can check out. It's in the description. Go check out that offer in detail. It's pretty awesome for those who are linking Shopify and PayPal for the first time. Now, PayPal also has a express checkout shortcut mechanism. And in order to enable that, there's a free Shopify app. I'll give a link to that in the description below as well. Now, if you guys didn't know, PayPal is trusted by over 325 million customers worldwide, and it offers a one-click integration with Shopify, which is of course our preferred way of running an e-commerce business. Even Shopify has brought out a bunch of offers. They've partnered up with app developers and other services to bring out like a huge bundle of offers for you to take advantage of as you get back to business. I'll give a link to all the details in the description below. Now listen guys, this is a huge opportunity for us e-commerce merchants. Even sectors like real estate and the automobile industry are shifting a lot of their processes online. Well, if people have started buying their homes and their cars online, it's a big, big opportunity for us all. COVID-19 has accelerated the shift to online that was already happening before. It's just accelerated that shift, and it is a huge opportunity for us e-commerce merchants. Are you excited now? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I wish you all the best as you get back to business.